Let me ask you a question. Did you hear about the story of Abraham in the Quran?
Story of Abraham. Oh, yes, yes, of course.
Okay.
So what are you talking about? The one with his son?
With one what?
Are you talking about Abraham and his son?
Yeah, but how Abraham became a Muslim?
Oh, right. Is Abraham a Muslim? Yeah.
Yeah. How he became a Muslim, do you know?
I didn't know Abraham was a Muslim.
It is the most funny, stupid stories ever you can imagine.
I came after Abraham.
It's the most funny, stupid story you can imagine. Chapter 6. We can go. And we'll read, we can read it from verse number 76, verse 78, 79, etc. You will see that it says, Abraham, Allah is reciting for us the story of Abraham, how Abraham became a Muslim. Look how this funny story, childish story. It says, so also when we show Abraham the power and the laws, how he showed him, read this. When the night covered him, who, Abraham, he saw a star. He said, this is my Allah. But when he saw it is set, he said, I love not those who set. What do you think? What do you think? Do you really believe in such a stupid story? Why? Abraham, he never saw the star set before. Abraham now is a man. What do you mean he saw the star and then he saw the sun? He noticed that the star set. First of all, the star never set. The star is there, correct?
Mm-hmm.
It is the earth is moving around itself and the star is not disappearing, at least from its place. It is there. When we say the sun set, this is not true. We can accept that as a figure of speech, but the fact there's no sunset, correct? Okay, but here Allah is giving us the reason why Abraham, he changed his religion from worshiping the star. Why? Because the sunset. Okay, then second day, or maybe after a few years, when he saw the moon rising in splendor, he said, this is my Lord. Look how stupid this answer here. Aren't you the one who just said that because the star set, he rejected the star?
Okay.
Okay. Are you saying to me he never saw the moon before?
That's what I was thinking.
So what does that mean? The moon never set in the time of Abraham and suddenly it set? The moon was always there? So when he saw the moon rising in splendor, he said, this is my Lord. But when the moon set, he said, I don't like, unless Allah guide me, my Lord guide me, I shall surely among those who go astray. And then look at this, the madness. When he saw the sun rising in splendor, he said, this is my Lord, this is Akbar. You see here, they say the word greatest. It doesn't say that, it says Akbar. Akbar was the name of the God, which is the God of the sun. This is why the Muslims, they say Allahu Akbar, which means God of the moon and God of the sun are united. Tawheed, one God.
One.
The God of the sun and the God of the sun is Allah. The God of the moon, the God of the moon is Allah. The God of the sun is Akbar. So when Abraham, he saw the sun rising, he said, this is my God, this is Akbar. Okay, question.
Okay, I follow what you're saying, but then to take it a step back and then to look at the Old Testament, and then why is it that the believers in the Old Testament don't necessarily believe in the Bible?
What do you mean? What
so
do you mean?
People are Jews today.
What was
Jesus?
Say again.
So Jesus was a Jew, yeah. Jesus was a Jew, and there are still Jews today who don't believe in Jesus.
My friend. There is a Christians today, they don't believe in Christ. They call themselves Christians, they are false. But in the same time, hold on. Did you ask my question? Let me answer, my friend.
Okay, we can answer.
Who said that Jews did not believe in Jesus? All the apostles of Jesus are Jews. All of them. The one, you see, I am not a Jew, I am an Arab, and the one who brought Christianity to me, he was a Jew. So how we say that Jews did not believe? Actually, the majority of the Jews are already Christians. Because after 2,000 years of Christ, how many Jews we have in the world? 13, 14 million? Is that possible? Where they go? Because they are gone through Christianity. There's a lot of Jews, origin Jews, who they became Christians. So it is the opposite, not what you think. The majority of the Jews already, they are Christians, and the minority of the Jews, they are still Jews. However, today there's people who they are atheists. Is that to prove that Jesus is false?
No, it doesn't prove it.
There's people who they are communists. There's people who they are gays. There's people who they are lesbian. There's people, you know, freedom. People, freedom bring a lot of things, my friend. Freedom, in order to know who is who, give a freedom. If you force everybody to wear hijab, then we do not know really how many of them they care to wear hijab as something willingly. Because we force everybody, same as in Saudi Arabia, they force everybody to pray. But we do not, there's no way in Saudi Arabia, the whole country is a believer. Nobody is a gay or lesbian or an atheist or etc. So having Jews who they are still Jews, that will not change anything about who is Jesus. Let us say, for the sake of argument, Jesus only 12 people, they follow him. Only. Until now, let us say until now, only 12 people follow him. That will not change anything. Since when?
Since when
the number, my friend, since when the number will make a difference about the truth? Because usually it is the opposite. The deceiving things is more popular. Like now, be honest with me. If I say to you, we want to go and help an older people who they cannot clean their houses, let us go and help them. And someone else, he said to you, we have a party in the bar, we have a free drink, we have girls are coming, and it's, which one is more attractive?
Well, the second one.
See, so here we go, which one? But it's obvious which one is the true one, the one we should do as a human. But always deceiving things is more attractive.